We are the FHNW Rover team from the Fachhochschule Nordwestschweiz, FHNW, based in the northwest of Switzerland. Our new rover Wambo represents our dedication to innovation as students at the FHNW. Hello, I'm Philipp, I'm the team lead and responsible for the organization and coordination of the rover, even on the technical side. Our team consists of 25 students from different majors, electrical and mechanical engineering and computer science. Most of us are fourth semester bachelor degree students who work on the rover as their semester project. For the science part, we have geologic and bioanalytics students who do the science missions. In addition, we benefit from the support of our previous team members who share their experience from past competition and provide in-depth knowledge of the rover system. To encourage interdisciplinary collaboration, we organize ourselves into work packages, mixing different majors so that every team member contributes their unique expertise. The subteams synchronize themselves under each other and we come together as a whole team every month to show our efforts and share updates.
My name is Adrian and I'm the safety engineer of the team and I'm making sure that all people and materials stay safe.
I'm Andrea, representing the electronic team. We develop the rover's control system and also improve existing systems.
This is Luca. I'm responsible for the mechanics of the deep sampling. For this year, we made the deep sampling modular while shedding as much weight as possible and keeping last year's efficiency.
My name is Tim. I'm representing the computer science team and I'm driving the rover.
Hello, I am Ciro Kovo. I'm head of the drone team. This is our drone, Melifera. I'm also the operator of our manipulator.
Hi, my name is David. I'm currently working on this year's drone for the European Rover Challenge. We're competing with a hexacopter, which ensures high flight stability and extended flight time. Last year, we didn't win the award for the best performance in the navigation drone category. But this year, we're aiming for it and we're confident we will get it.
My name is Luca Wüttrich and I'm head of science. I'm responsible for the collaboration work of geologists, biologists, as well as the electrical engineers, especially for the tasks astrobio and science exploration. We want to take part in the ERC because it's an incredible experience where we get to meet teams from all over the world. Seeing how other teams solve the same challenges as we do gives us fresh ideas and inspires us to try out something entirely new. So once you've experienced the ERC finals, you want to keep coming back. It's such a unique and inspiring experience that it pushes you to improve, keep on working, and aim higher every single time. And that is why we would like to be a part of the ERC finals again.
This year, we focused on making our chassis with carbon fiber, so it's lighter, and we also made it more modular. With this redesign, we added new mounting holes for external sensors, as well as a new feature that helps us in our development process. We now can remove the deep sampling module, the manipulator, or even both. While building our rover Wambo, this helped with iterating and testing those subsystems, while other subteams could still test on Wambo. And since it only takes around 5 minutes to swap parts, we see that as a real advantage to adopt Wambo for different tasks at the ERC and use only the necessary tools to save on weight. A new LiDAR improves our navigation while driving autonomously. As an example, the rover can now decide to take a direct route over a hill or find a safe way around it. To optimize our network connection with you, we only request the newest frame of our cameras if needed. Our goal is to reduce latency and improve quality, especially in a congested spectrum. To read out new sensors or control the deep sampling, we have a new custom board which connects sensors and actors with a CAN bus. When plugging in a new system, the capabilities are advertised automatically over an IP connection. In the background, we saw the cycling of colors of the beacon controlled over the board.
This is Mellifera. It tells the story of a honeybee exploring its surroundings and landing precisely on a flower. The name Mellifera is derived from the Latin name for the honeybee, Apis mellifera. The design is inspired by the features of a bee, a hexagonal frame, six legs, and a color scheme of yellow and black reflecting both the bee and the color of our university, FHNW.
Now we are demonstrating the autoland sequence after a communication loss, simulated by turning off the remote control.
Our deep sampling unit uses a capstan type winch with Dyneema rope to move the drilling sled. The winch solely relies on friction to work, but does so reliably, thus making the whole assembly very lightweight, almost cutting the weight of last year's deep sampling in half. It can also be fully removed when not in use, further lightening our rover. The swing in storage mechanism operates fully mechanically, with the sole exception of the load cell, which measures the weight of the soil sample, of course. The deep sampling unit is still under construction. For example, some components, such as the cameras for the ground imaging, are still missing.
After a long workday, we need a refreshment. Luckily, our manipulator can reach the better beer at our local supermarket.